Tesla and NHTSA issued a Model Y recall for wonky trailer brake light. Not all Model Y SUVs come with a trailer brake, but a couple thousands need an over-the-air update. But it has caused a Tesla and NHTSA review. Both have confirmed a new recall landed for the Tesla Model Y and for those owners with the optional trailer brake light. You need to keep an eye out of a new software update. Welcome back, dear friends. This is Armin Haryan from torquenews.com. If you are here for the first time, please subscribe to our channel and ring the bell so you don't miss my next Tesla story. So according to NHTSA document on the Tesla Model Y recall published with the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration today, Model Y vehicles may have glitched software that prevents the light from illuminating. Not too many Model Ys, you know, are part of this recall because there are only a couple of thousands of them that have this hitch. But NHTSA and Tesla said 2,567 Model Ys are included. We don't know, however, says CNET, how many Model Y SUVs Tesla has actually built. If Tesla delivered a chunk of them with the trailer brake lights, then it's a more significant recall than the figure on that that is suggested by CNET. And then CNET says, since the software error keeps the light from doing the job and lighting up, the Teslas failed to comply with Federal Motor Safety Vehicle Safety Standards and must be recalled. Since Teslas are awfully well connected, there is no need for owners to take their cars to a service center. Instead, Tesla released a new over-the-air software update that will fix the problem free of charge for all owners. Of course, if it's a recall, it's free of charge fixed. According to NHTSA, the update began rolling out last month. Now, I just don't know if this is if Tesla owners that have this problem don't need to take their cars to service centers, why do they call it a recall? You know, why couldn't Tesla just quietly, you know, or not quietly, but just announce the software update and say, hey, we have this problem, here's the fix. So there is the descriptive information of the problem on NHTSA's document. The subject population includes all Tesla Model Y vehicle equipped with a global rear lamp variant and tow package confirmation. Description of the non-compliance: FMVSS requires stop lamps on the rear of all trailers, which must be activated upon application of the service brakes. A software error in certain Model Y vehicles may prevent illumination of trailer brake lights up actuation of the service brake. Lamps, reflective devices, and associated equipment are involved in this. And description of the safety risk says this condition may result in inoperative trailer brake light. I don't know what the consequences of that would be. And the description of the cause, it says, on August 10, 2020, Tesla introduced a new global rear lamp variant into production for Model Y. The new rear lamp variant introduced a new channel into the vehicle control module, which the software did not properly map to the integrated trailer control module. So here's the entire problem. Tesla created a new variant for the rear map. There is a new map and actually new channel in its software, and the channel did not properly map to the integrated trailer control module. If you look at the chronology, it says on August 22nd, 2020, Tesla service received an appointment request for a Model Y customer who reported that their trailer brake lights were inoperative. And an appointment was scheduled for September 17th. On September 16, 2020, an internal validation team separately identified a discrepancy in brake light activation during trailer light regression testing, although the cause and full consequence was not yet known. On September 21 of 2020, the engineering team at Tesla received a service escalation related to the customer concern and immediately commenced an investigation identified the firmware issue and created a firmware fix. And on September 23, 2020, you see, within basically 1 month, Tesla determined that a non-compliance exists. Tesla will remedy, the document says, this non-compliance with firmware release 2020.36.12. So look for that software update known as 2020.36.12. Tesla will remedy this issue with that update, which was released over the air actually to vehicles in the field on or about September 23, 2020. The fix will be carried forward in firmware release 2020.40.3 and later. As of this filing, more than 97% of the affected VIN population has installed firmware release 2020.36.12 or a later release containing the correction. So basically, as of this time, 97% of the issue is solved. Firmware release 2020.36.12 corrects the mapping of the rear lamp to the trailer control module, and factory firmware release 2020.35.101.06, which corrects the software mapping error, was introduced in production on September 22, 2020. Regarding the recall schedule, it says all Tesla stores and service centers will be notified on or about October 2, 2020. Owner notification letters will be mailed in accordance with 49 CFR. Friends, if you are part of this recall, or if your Tesla is part of this recall, have you received a notification letter already from Tesla? Let me know what you found there, and if there's any information that we need to know to report or to add to this story. But I'm glad that, you see, one of the fun things about Tesla recalls is that just a simple software update and software remapping and can fix an entire recall, and also make recall cheaper for Tesla. You don't have to take your car back to Tesla center. You don't have to, Tesla doesn't have to apply manpower, labor cost, and so on, and equipment to fix it. They just do an over the air software update and your Tesla is fixed. I think that's a good thing, and this is maybe going to be one of the future major points in automotive industry. So let me know what your thoughts are, friends, on this way of recalling. And in the meantime, this is Armin Harayan from torquenews.com. Please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla news and ring the notification bell so you don't miss my next Tesla story. And I'll see you in our next report. God bless you. Take good care of each other. Peace be with all of you.